couple of weeks at number 10, where she peaked. She falls to 15 this week with Baby Love. This is Casey on AT40 in Hollywood. Now we're up to the song Heartbeat, the first hit record for one of TV's hottest stars, that cool cop with no socks, Don Johnson. Now, you might think that Don is just the latest screen star to cash in on his popularity and take a shot at getting a hit record. But listen to his story. Don has been a serious actor for more than 15 years. You can still catch him on The Late Show in old movies like The Herod Experiment and the science fiction cult film A Boy and His Dog. And there have been some smaller roles for Don in a few TV movies. Well, a couple of years ago, he was cast in the role of Sonny Crockett in a new show called Miami Vice. Suddenly, he's just about the hottest thing on TV. But what some people may not know is that long before he thought about acting, Don Johnson was into music. He grew up in Flat Creek, Missouri, and says that, "I've been a singer ever since I was 6 years old, singing my grandfather's church." Don grew up with Dickie Betts, who himself grew up to become the guitarist in the Allman Brothers Band. In the early 70s, Don even co-wrote a few songs on Allman Brothers albums. Over the years, as he struggled to build an acting career, Don's interest in music simmered on the back burner. Now, secure with an acting job and a hit TV series, Don can afford to turn up the heat under his music. But he told writer Rip Rentz, "I had misgivings about it because obviously I already have a healthy career. If I didn't feel I could make a credible music statement, then I probably wouldn't have done it." End of quote. Well, Don's credibility is very intact. Rolling Stone magazine said, "The album Heartbeat is a..."
From the Napa.com studios, this is Toledo's greatest hits music station, z.73 wjdn, an independent radio station. It's Casey Kasem's American Top 40 Music Countdown on WJDN.
Johnson was into music. He grew up in Flat Creek, Missouri, and says that, "I've been a singer ever since I was 6 years old, singing my grandfather's church." Don grew up with Dickie Betts, who himself grew up to become the guitarist in the Allman Brothers Band. In the early 70s, Don even co-wrote a few songs on Allman Brothers albums. Over the years, as he struggled to build an acting career, Don's interest in music simmered on the back burner. Now, secure with an acting job and a hit TV series, Don can afford to turn up the heat under his music. But he told writer Rip Rentz, "I had misgivings about it because obviously I already have a healthy career. If I didn't feel I could make a credible music statement, then I probably wouldn't have done it." End of quote. Well, Don's credibility is very intact. Rolling Stone magazine said, "The album Heartbeat is a shrewd and seductive record, an impeccably produced commercial rock album that ranges comfortably across several contemporary styles." Unquote. With the title song from that album, his first hit, here's Don Johnson climbing six notches to number 14, Heartbeat.
"I don't care what you say, you can give it away. Your money don't mean much to me. I've been out on my own for very long now, 'cause that's the way it's got to be. Everybody tells me how I can beat the odds for now. I've been standing by the fire, just can't feel the heat, can't feel the heat.
Price moves up six notches, fourth week in the countdown to number 14 with Heartbeat. Here's one from the 1840 Book of Trivia. In the rock era, only two artists ever have hit number one in these three ways: singing solo, singing in a duo, and singing in a trio. One of those artists is the Princess Di of the record charts. The other, an Englishman named Philip. Details coming up.
Casey's Coast to Coast.
A-Team has Mr. T, AT40 has Ms. T. Talking about double T, TNT as in dynamite. Tina Turner, her 15th top 40 hit is at number 13 this week. It's Typical Male.
Tell me, liar, what to do. Yeah.
44th week in the countdown, she moves up six notches to number 13 with her 15th top 40 hit, Typical Male. Now let's open the 1840 Book of Trivia to the only two artists in the rock era ever to have hit number one singing solo, singing in a duo, and singing in a trio. The first artist to do it hit number one singing solo on songs like Upside Down. She hit number one in a duo singing with Lionel Richie on the number one hit, Endless Love. And she hit number one many times singing with a trio on songs like You Can't Hurry Love. That trio was the Supremes. And she, of course, is the Princess Di of our record charts, Diana Ross. Only one other artist has done what she's done, and he's an Englishman. He's hit number one singing solo on songs like One More Night. He hit number one in a duo with Marilyn Martin singing Separate Lives. And he recently hit number one singing with a trio on the song Invisible Touch. His trio is Genesis, and he's Phil Collins. Phil Collins and Diana Ross, the rock era's only singers to hit number one solo, with a duo, and with a trio. And in case you're wondering, Paul McCartney has never officially hit number one solo. From the 1840 Book of Chart Trivia. Now, here's Phil Collins singing with that trio, with Mike Rutherford and Tony Banks. Together, they're Genesis at number 12, Throwing It All Away. number 12. There's nothing I can say. You're throwing it all away. That's Genesis on American Top 40, moving up 5 notches. 11 big ones to number 1 as our countdown continues. We're getting closer and closer to number 1. This next act's chart history reads like this. Conga, Bad Boy, and Words Get in the Way. 3 consecutive top 10s for the Miami Sound Machine. They fall from 5 to 11 this week with that third top 10 of theirs. Words Get in the Way.
I realize you're seeing someone new. I don't believe she knows you like I do. Your temperament will moody side, the one you always try to hide from me. But I know when you have something on your mind, you've been trying to tell me time. And before you break my heart in two, there's something I've been trying to say to you. But the words get in the way. There's so much I want to say, but it's locked deep inside, and if you look in my eyes, we might fall in love again. So won't even start to fly before we say goodbye. I try to say I love you, but the words got in the way. Your heart has always been in the winter, but baby, I don't even know you anymore. And despite the fact it's hurting me, I know the time has come to set you free.
Sound Machine with one of 10 ballads in our countdown this week, falling from number 5 to number 11. Words Get in the Way. You're hearing the 40 biggest hits in the USA, and the hits don't stop till we get to the top.
Number 10.
Billy Ocean climbs a notch to get his 6th top 10 hit out of 8 chart records. Not bad. Here's Low Zone.
Yeah. Don't you
40 biggest hits in the land. I'm Casey Kasem. This is American Top 40, and we're on our way to the number one song in the USA.
Number nine.
Here's the recent number one song by the band Berlin. Singer Terry Nunn, keyboardist John Crawford, and guitarist Rob Brill. It's the love theme from Top Gun. Take My Breath Away.
Jealous, 'cause we always stay together. Yeah, baby.
Notches this week. Two of hearts. This is Casey Kasem on AT40 in Hollywood. Now we're up to our long distance dedication. It's from a teenage girl in San Antonio, Texas, who's learned hard lessons about reality. Here's what she writes. Dear Casey, I'm a 17-year-old girl who started running away at the age of 12. I was like millions of kids out there on the streets. I just wanted the love I couldn't get at home. But it's not fun being out in the streets, especially not knowing where your next meal is coming from, or if you'll have a bench or a cold floor to sleep on. Twice, I took a chance at getting rides from men that looked nice, only to end up getting raped. After all this, I felt lonely and depressed. I tried suicide, but even that failed. I finally found inner peace by being able to accept myself the way I am. I've changed a lot during the past year, and I'm living at home again. But the nightmares will stay forever in my mind, because they're engraved there. My dedication goes out to all the rest of my generation who think things are better out in the streets, as I once did. Casey, please play The Greatest Love of All for all the young teenagers at home, and most of all, the ones in the streets. Signed, Mary. Mary, here's your long-distance dedication.
Show them all the beauty they possess inside. San Antonio, Texas, to all her fellow teens at home who have thought about running away to a life on the streets, and most of all, to teens who are out on the streets, as the countdown continues. We're counting down to Billboard's number one song.
Number seven.
Here's the number one song on the dance chart, the latest smash by Janet Jackson. This week it makes a seven-notch leap on the pop chart, When I Think of You. Thank you. Jackson on American Top 40, moving up 7 notches, 6th week in the survey, to number 7 with When I Think of You, her 3rd Top 40 pop hit. Next in the countdown is Dream Time, a solo hit by Daryl Hall, co-produced by Dave Stewart of Eurythmics, who's been pretty busy in the past year or so. He's worked with Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers and with Bob Dylan, too. In this week's countdown, we heard him back at number 16 with Eurythmics. And the song Dave Stewart co-produced with Daryl Hall is at number 6 this week. Here's Dream Time.